Still loving that music, aren't you?
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Today Show. We just love that music, we love you joining us, irrespective of whether or not you like that music or
not. That's true.
We don't like it, do we?
We're not crazy about it. Given the power that you've had over some of our promo songs that we've been running, you've noticed my voice is going a little bit. I think I need.
I just had the cold.
Yeah, look. Look who's wearing it now. Thank you very much.
That's because you spent half of the last week flying around the world.
Well, I'm sorry about that.
I'm sitting over here for the rest of the show.
No, I clearly took it with me.
I don't think Georgie would like that.
Oh, dear, I'm not very popular this morning, Ben.
I love you, Lisa.
Thank you, Ben.
And guess what?
Come and sit next to me.
Go and make her a cup of tea.
I love, you know what? You know what else I love?
Yes.
I love the intro music too.
Oh, do you?
I do too, actually.
That makes you really sleazy, Ben.
Oh.
It's that kind of music. That's the problem with it.
What? It's make-out music?
You're sleazy, Ben.
That's wrong.
Let's see what the weather's
doing. You're not winning any friends this morning.
I clearly am not, as I sit on my own.
The first edition will be published in 9 languages and is set to sell around 1 million copies. So if the Pontiff ever quits his day job, he's got a promising career as a writer. There you go. There's a stocking filler if you need one.
You might need to, the way things are going.
This is true.
Maybe they could turn it into a trilogy like the Twilight series or something.
Just
like
have vampires in it, right, Fordo? Mm.
Yeah, throw
anything
a couple
with
a
vampire goes like hotcakes at the moment.
Were there any Wolverines in the Bible?
Haven't you read the Bible?
Not lately.
You are a heathen, aren't you?
I haven't read it lately. Doesn't make me a heathen.
Do you know that you're going to hell?
Thank you for that.
Where will you be on Judgment Day, Carl?
I'll be in hell as well.
That'll be fun. You'll be there at the pearly... Well, not the pearly gates. What are they?
The fiery gates.
The
iron
gates.
It's like a big nightclub. You've got to have a certain ID to get in.
It's got a disco ball.
But, yeah, and I'll have the fluoro around my neck.
I bet you will. Do you need one of those stamps?
Yeah, there's all sorts of stamps.
Under the blue light?
Oh, yeah. They've still got their battles, haven't they, the church?
That's true. May as well party on.
Forget romance. Researchers say you really can laugh a girl into bed.
Particularly in Australia, I
100%.
Think. We like a bit of a laugh.
Love
and we love
a laugh.
Someone who can take the mickey out of themselves.
And then not only laugh us into bed, but laugh when you're in bed as well.
Yes, because that can
be funny. That's funny.
Very funny.
Laughing with you, not at you.
That can be
how funny can it be?
That can be uncomfortable.
Finally, you could see the mental pictures going through Georgie in my mind right now as we cast our minds back.
That's one of the best belly laughs in bed.
It's always funny when you laugh at blokes, isn't it? And their problems.
We're laughing at them.
No, we're not laughing at blokes. Well,
not all of us can look like Dickie, you know?
Why are you folding your script nervously?
Into a stick.
I don't want to talk about it.
Wow, we've hit a raw nerve.
We're going to get today's weather now, which is going to be really cool. I told you it was going to... That looked a bit odd. That looked a bit odd.
I didn't know we were coming
back. No, you didn't, but it was cool. Oh, it's like Game of Thrones.
Wow, fantastic. How good are jousting sticks?
Where do you get these jousting sticks from?
I think Trading Post.
How much are they?
Oh, I think about $240, Carl.
$240?
$240.
For jousting sticks?
For jousting sticks.
Tell them they're dreaming.
Oh, well.
Psst. Don't leave me hanging.
Oh.
Now let's give it a big fist pump. Ready? 3, 2, 1. We knocked that one out of the park. And finally, the Northern Territory news, dumb and bummer. A woman crashed her car after being distracted by her passenger who was trying to moon a semi-trailer as they overtook it on the Stuart Highway. Now, that is a Monday morning front page.
Don't you love how they had cameras on the scene as it happened?
I think that's a dramatic reenactment.
Do you think so?
Yeah.
How can you tell, Carl?
Because the undies are clean, Lisa.
Good point.
Nobody has clean undies in the Northern Territory.
Good morning
to you,
Charles.
It's not even a proper mooning.
I mean, Crocs would do it to you.
It's not even a proper... Mooning.
It's a bad move.
Is it?
Off with the balaclava, on with the briefs. Melbourne police are searching for this man who wore undies over his head to rob a service station at Knife Point. Now, the robber entered the business in Deer Park on February 15, demanding cash. No one was hurt in the incident. Now, for all you old school cartoon fans, remember Fat Albert? We've seen it all before, haven't we? Remember that? And what's his name again? Dumb Donald. So if you've seen Dumb Donald or this bloke, contact Crime Stoppers. Lisa?
Get excited, Bandage Bear.
Bandage Bear's eyes are freaking me out.
Okay. it's a little bit of a heat issue here this morning, Carl.
Look at it, he's not moving. That would freak you out if you're in hospital.
He's not well, Carl.
He's not moving. He needs to go upstairs, I think. Have a little lie down. He's just lifted the hotter meter, hasn't he?
I think he's off the scale.
They are magnificent arms.
Watch out, anyone playing against him.
Wow.
There you go.
You'd want to be on him, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
I don't mean it like that.
I'm glad you don't mean
you
it.
What
like
are they marking him? Yes. Dirty mind.
I think we all do.
I think he's looking at you.
I was looking at you, Lisa.
You're the one who said it.
He's got
exactly.
Lovely
out of the arms. Mouths of babes.
Now, look, I have to acknowledge that he's got lovely arms.
I just called
kangaroo.
You a babe.
Kangaroos have strong arms.
No, they don't.
Yes, they do. Have
kangaroos have them? Little paws.
Ooh,
like
look at
this.
Your little arms, kangaroo. What are you going to do with those?
Well,
like,
you know
how
what
does
I
the
mean.
Boxing kangaroo term come about?
Yeah, exactly.
Like, they're boxing no one.
They're good kickers.
They just go their karate kick.
Anyway, we digress.
Oh, my mask is coming off. I'm having some problems here with my mask coming off. Now, if you would like to try this out.
Oh, hello.
Just head on to manlysanctuary.com.au.
Wow.
Is he okay?
Yeah, he's okay.
He's okay.
Gee, that was full on, wasn't it?
He has a quite an astounding ability to make the animal kingdom fall in love with him.
Magnetism.
It is.
They do strange things.
They're the camels. Yeah, the camels.
Pelicans.
The stingray is now falling in love with
the roosters.
Chicken. Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Pelicans. Oh. Turtles. Look at the turtle. Poor turtle. Doesn't know where his lover's gone.
Looks rejected, doesn't it? Mm-hmm.
He's shell-shocked, Lisa.
Oh! Stevie, okay?
Oh.
And Gabbana gown.
Good earrings.
Gorgeous. She'll always be Charlene to me, though.
Yeah, that was fine work in Neighbours. Oh. Hard to top that. Yeah.
I can't stand those arty films. Like, you go and see things like, oh, what happened there, what happened there, what happened there, what happened there? Mm. Like Mulholland Drive. A great film, then, like, just what happened there? Too many questions, it's just all about the art.
But
give
you,
me A-Team any day.
Are you one of those people who, during the film, say, what happened? I missed that bit.
No, because I'm just like...
But a great opportunity to have a choc top.
Yeah,
I agree. With popcorn in the top,
correct.
See,
yeah,
much more
so
basic.
It's never a lost opportunity. Carl.
That's right.
Very basic human being.
Love spending $45 on an ice cream and popcorn.
Don't go to one of those movies with a simple mate because I've got a mate Cameron and I went to the Usual Suspects. Remember the Usual Suspects? Mm-hmm. And he sat there the whole time going, "Who's this guy?"
Yeah, yeah.
For me, it was Inception.
I loved Inception.
Oh, see, I loathed Inception. Yeah. I didn't know what was happening.
Didn't get it at all.
Yeah.
Walked my out. Kids keep saying to me, "See it four times, Mum, and you'll get it." I don't. My life's too short.
Yeah, yeah.
More movie reviews. Coming up in the next hour.
Nice. What about in The Crying Game when the hot chick turned out to be a hot bloke?
I don't think we should talk about The Crying Game.
Don't give away the endings.
No.
I love arty films.
David Beckham, this is a weird one, talk show host, Richard. Carl's just asking the obvious question. You know what, when David fronts the cameras, first night on the show,
yes,
the David Beckham show,
yes.
Probably called, what would he say?
David, he would say, oh, no... Does that red light mean we're on TV?
Right.
You couldn't do live.
Yeah, it does, and the answer would be yes.
Loves all the animals here at the park, and we are going to show you more of his favourites a little throughout the morning. Shall we have a frog hat?
Mm.
Frog hat! We'll see you back here in the next little while, Carl and Georgie.
Little Charlie.
Ever
quite
since
the
I was a kid, I've been scared of green frogs. When I was in Cairns, I went to the loo and my uncle made me, like, I had to go to the toilet. And anyway, there was a green frog in the toilet. And it was just, I was only like five, and I've gone, and I freaked out, and I've had a problem with green frogs ever since.
Red frog.
Fair enough.
I can't look at them. Did you notice I wasn't looking at them?
No. How are you with a cane toad then?
No, cane toads we used to hit with the...
We don't want to know about that. Let's get some entertainment, Dickie. Move it along, please, Dickie.
Yeah.
He's got cheeks that you just want to pinch,
yeah.
Doesn't he?
He's like the Gangnam Style, isn't he?
He's a little bit Gangnam.
Very much so.
It's scary.
There he is.
He's doing Gangnam.
He was just doing it.
That's him just pressing a nuclear warhead.
Looks like he'd be good in a game of charades.
Horses for courses.
That's power. They do say that power is an aphrodisiac.
You'd be
correct.
Sucking up
that's
to him,
it right
you?
There.
Oh, yeah. Here on today. So that's going to be good.
Odd looking people in New Zealand, aren't they?
No, well,
can I share something odd, just quickly?
I've
picked up
attention.
A copy of the latest Observer magazine, and they've got a day in the life of Carl Stefanovic.
Mm.
Oh, yeah.
And we all know how odd he is. But I love this, because out of all the things you could share about your life, because they spend a day in the life of him, he says, on the weekend, if he's not at the park with his three children, he spends time at the local butcher's sourcing the best types of the South African delicacy, biltong. Mm.
Stanley Street Butcher.
What's wrong with you?
What's wrong with biltong? The South African players, that's what they've been munching on since they got here. That's why they're not playing well.
That's where you
got
can
all that
find
meat
him.
In their
if he's not at the park, he's, at the
he's getting biltong.
Right. Did any of us get sort of interviewed to give
that's
interesting.
Boy, that's Carl's perspective.
Well, they asked us to. Anyway, I'm not going to comment any further on that.
Would biltong, you not be found hanging out with us, your friends?
No, I'd rather not.
You're buying biltong.
I don't
even know why you asked that.
Honestly, it's just an illusion, this whole TV thing.
Biltong.
So it's either the park with the kids or
it's the kids or biltong.
I don't like you. I love it. I don't care. I love it.